Hey, happy Sunday, everybody.
Happy Sunday, everybody.
Woo, yes, it is Sunday.
Sunday, favorite day of the week.
Yes, yes, yes. And man, we're so excited to be with you guys today.
Absolutely.
Whether you're joining in on our morning services or one of our evening services, man, we are just happy that we are here with you.
So happy.
Yes, yes. Hey, by the way, my name is Mike.
And my name is Cheryl.
My beautiful wife, Cheryl. Honey, you're looking very, very beautiful today.
Oh, thank you, darling.
Yes, yes, yes.
You look pretty dabber yourself.
My Christmas sweater.
Your Christmas
Come on.
Sweater.
Yes, yes, yes. And so we just want to say welcome, welcome, welcome. Hey, we are your online campus pastors, man. And we're just honored to be able to come into your homes. Mm-hmm. Hey, if this is your first time joining us, honey, what do we want them to do if this is their first time?
We would like for you to actually type in the chat. Our team is waiting to
yes.
greet you and meet you. Let them know. Just type the word first. They will know it is your first time. Let us know your name and where you're watching us from.
Yes, yes. And also, we would like for you to text multiply to 94,000.
Yes.
And that way you can go in and sign up, get connected, man, because we'd like to know who you are, and our team would like to connect with you.
Yes.
And we want to just direct you at what's next here at Destiny as one of our first time guests. Well, man, we have so many things that's going on.
Lots of things.
But what we want you guys to do is make sure that you are prepared, because during the service today, during Pastor Obed's message, we're gonna be having communion together as a family.
Yes.
Yes, and we have a communion together because we just are in the midst of breaking our 21 day fast.
Let's celebrate.
Yes, yes.
Time for celebration, yes.
Yes.
We just completed 21 days of prayer and fasting, life and leadership with Pastor Obed
yes.
every morning
wow.
at 6 o'clock. I made it, you made it. We are going to celebrate for breaking our fast.
Yes,
21
yes.
days strong.
Yes, breaking our fast, man, 21 days finishing strong. You know, I was sharing, honey, with the worship team in our devotion this past week, is that in those 21 days, there's been some things that I found out that was essential and non-essential in my life.
Wow.
And I don't want to go back to those non-essentials. I mean, those things I thought I needed.
Yeah.
And being able to, like, I hold, you know, 21 days of the fast and breaking bad habits.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I mean, that was great. It was good.
It was, I broke bad habits.
Yes, yes. I mean, we even created new habits, new
Absolutely.
Good, healthy habits.
Yes.
You know, getting up earlier.
It's just been an amazing 21 days. You know, I hate to see it come to an end, but I'm even more excited about what's next. Where am I going to journey to after finishing these 21 days? How am I going to implement these new good habits
yes.
that I now have since
yes.
I've gotten rid of the bad habits?
Yes, yes. Well, it was just the whole thing. It was a disciples' discipline
yes.
for healthy living.
Yes.
Yes. So, yes, man, we're so excited. So, honey, there's so many things that we got going on this week and for this month. One of the things is that today we're kicking off our life groups.
That's right.
Yes, life groups are today.
Life groups are today. If you want to get connected and get plugged into one of our life groups, you can either go to our Destiny Church app, if you already have that downloaded, or you can go to destiny.online/life groups.
Yes.
And there you can get connected.
Yes.
Life is so much better when you do it together
yes.
and grow
yes.
in groups.
Yes. Yes. We grow in groups doing life together.
Yes.
Hey, by the way, if you're just joining us, my name is Mike. This is my beautiful wife.
Cheryl.
We are your online campus pastors, man. And we're so happy that you're here. And not only that, we forgot to tell you, hey, if you got kiddos, we want to get those connected too. We want to get your kiddos connected.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Our kids ministry team, they have something planned that's so exciting, over the top. They are so creative. We never know what the kids are going to be doing. So get your kids plugged in. They're going to thank you for doing that for them, because it is going to be amazing today.
It's going to be amazing. Yes, all day today, man. So many things are happening. So, honey, what else is happening? We got so many great things.
Well, we got Winning Wednesday coming up.
Yes, yes.
This Wednesday, Pastor Obed will be delivering his State of the Church address for 2021.
Mm.
He's going to be explaining
five things
that are going to affect our lives going on into 2021.
Yes.
You don't want to miss that service. So much information is going to be poured into us. I can't wait.
Yes, it's the State of the Church, man. And it's like so many things. there's so many things that's going to be growing that, yes. that God has for us mm-hmm. as a church family, and not only just as a church family, but for your family.
Absolutely.
Yes, and I mean, so man,
I love surprises.
Yeah, me too.
It's
yeah.
a big surprise. Yeah. No yeah. one knows yes. what Pastor's going to be talking to us about.
You know, Pastor always, he's such a visionary, you know? Yes. You know, he always tells us three things that he does. Vision cast.
That's right.
So his vision, man, is just beyond, man. And we're so blessed to have him and Pastor Lissette as our senior pastors. Yes. But hey, honey, guess what time it is?
Worship time already?
It's time for worship, oh but you ain't have your watch on, but it's time for worship. Hey we know that time. Yes. Skin time. Come on, girl. Hey, we're so excited. This is the time that you want to get rid of all distractions, man, yes. around you. This yes. is the time, man, that you can allow the presence of God to come into your home.
Saturation.
Yes, in your mm-hmm. home, man. You know, and we all know that in this time that we yes. need the presence of God in
You've
our
got
home.
To have the presence of
yes,
God.
Yes, yes. And if you have anyone in your house say, hey, I'm not, you know, in it, I guarantee you, if you turn on worship right now and let it just permeate your atmosphere in your home, it's going to change the whole situation.
Absolutely.
So we want you guys to join us in, man, for this time of service, honey. Everybody out there know the countdown. You guys ready?
Ready.
Here we go.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Let's worship.
Hello and welcome. Are you excited to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Come on, it's time to get our praise on. We're alive and well. There is a river where goodness flows. There is an ocean that drowns sorrows. There is a fountain deeper than sea. The tide is rising, rising. There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing from the heart of God. The flood of heaven crashing over.
that right where you are, God's promises are yes and amen. He's not slack concerning his promise. All you have to do, believe, and you shall receive. Whoa. Yeah. When the weight of life begins to fall, on the name of Jesus I will call. For I know my God is in control. His purposes are unshakable. Doesn't matter what I feel, doesn't matter what I see, my hope will always be your promises to me. Now casting out all fear, for your love to set me free, my hope will always be your promises to me. Yeah. Supplied my every need, oh, and your presence is enough for me. Yeah. Oh yeah, doesn't matter what I feel, doesn't matter what I see, my hope will always be your promises to me. Now casting out all fear, for your love to set me free, hope will always be your promises to me. Whoa, yes. Whoa, you will always be more than enough for me. You will always be more than enough for me. Nothing's gonna stop the plans you made. Nothing's gonna take your love away. You will always be more than enough for me. Come on. You will always be more than enough for me. Lift your voice, yeah. You will always be more than enough for me. Nothing's gonna stop the plans you made. Nothing's gonna take your love away. More than enough for me. Yeah. You will always be more than enough for me. Yeah. You will always be more than enough for me. Yeah. Nothing's gonna stop the plans you made. Nothing's gonna take your Doesn't matter what we see, I hope will always be your promises to me. Now casting out of fear, for your love to set me free, I hope will always be your promises to me. Doesn't matter what.
Over and over, Lord. We worship you with praise, Father. we just take this time to be with you right now, Father. When earthly fathers aren't present, Lord, we know that you, our Heavenly Father, are present to love us, to cover us. Thank you, Jesus, for guiding us.
What's up, everybody? Welcome. It is Sunday and fun day, man, and we get to be in the house of God. Worship was absolutely stunning, incredible. We are glad you are with us today. Hey, there's a couple of things that we would love for you to do, and that is every one of you that are watching either on a tablet or watch on a phone or a computer, you have a share button, and you can share with your people and your friends of this great experience called Destiny, and they can actually participate in it as well. So we'd encourage you to share it and talk about it and get others involved, because you never know who and it could be watching and get blessed by it.
Hey, hey, Destiny fam, come on, give us some hearts today. Mm-hmm. We are so honored to worship with you and to come into your homes wherever you're watching. Let's just continue to lean in for the entire service. And maybe this is your first time watching today. Just type in the comments there. Just write first. We'd love to get an opportunity to connect with you.
Yeah.
This is our opportunity for our giving as we keep our hearts postured towards worship. And so, you know, one of the things that you said today was just about our disciplines. And really, that really discipline is what gets us further in life. And so I just love this verse in Deuteronomy chapter 8, verses 17 and 18. It says, "Then you could say in your heart that my power and the might of my hand has gained me this wealth." But verse 18 says that you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is He who gives you the power to get wealth, that He would establish His covenant He swore to His fathers, as it is this day. It's a reminder.
Yes.
You know, when we include God in our giving, when we say, "God, I'm going to give you my first," when we say, "God, I'm going to give you my tithe today,"
it's a reminder
that we're putting God, and we're remembering, hey, it's not me. I'm not the one who put myself here. I'm not the one who put breath in my body.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not the one who was able to give us the power to get wealth. It was the Lord.
That's right. And you know, we're talking about habits, and the three R's are reminder, routine, and reward.
Oh, there you go.
And you know what happens, man, when we get paid, or I get paid from a client or a deal, that reminder, it's that trigger.
Yes.
And all of a sudden I'm like, let me go and push pay. I don't even wait. You know what I mean? I don't wait for a second. I just go and push pay. I pay my tithe. And guess what? That became a routine that ultimately brings me a reward. It's the right kind of habits, friends. And right now there's a trigger going on right now. You're either going to move into a routine and get the reward, or what you're going to do is you're going to say, "Oh, well, you know what? I'll wait till next time." And what's going to happen is you'll find going into your next season without a harvest. suffering the same type of suffering you're doing now. If you really want to change your life, change your habits in giving, and I promise you, you will get the rewards that God has for your life. So we're going to pray for your giving, and then we got someone special, some special people we'd love to introduce to you. Father, we thank you for those who are watching, God, as we get ready to give. We ask that you would bless people. Let that trigger take place so that routine can become a reward in their life. Mm-hmm. In Jesus' name, and all God's people say amen and amen. Amen. Well, hey, we're excited to announce to you our new youth pastors from our central location that's going to actually be working with all of our campuses. So we're going to invite Pastor Jeff and his lovely wife to come up here. Why don't you guys come in? Their lovely kids as well.
Give some hearts. Yeah, for give them some hearts, today. Right? Look at the beautiful
aren't they like
family.
The most good looking family in the world?
Let's
you know what
go.
I mean? I mean, aren't these kids like commercial kids or what? You know, I'm sitting there going like, the entrepreneurial mindset is going, girl, I'm going to sign you up to be my client right now. You know, I need to be your agent. You know what I mean? I mean, these are like kids that are like, oh my God. Like,
they're styling and profiling.
Man.
Let's go.
Oh, look at they take after mom and dad, right?
They take after their mom.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah.
Mom dresses everybody. Yeah,
that's a smart move right there. So, hey, tell us a little bit about yourself and all the people that are watching. There's a lot of parents that are watching that are going, yes,
yay!
We got to know you're going to want to connect with them. But tell us a little bit about yourself, man.
Yeah, so me and my wife, we have been together officially. Well, we've been married for 10 years. And we've been together 18 years.
Okay.
So, and my daughter, she is 8, Sarai. And my son is, he'll be 6 in 2 weeks, Uriah.
Yeah.
And we're just excited just to dig in, get to know each and every one of, like, the families, the parents, and
Amen.
The students, and just grow with them. And we just realize that it's not just about the students, it's about the family.
Mm. Yeah, I love that.
And we want to just help build the family, do life with all the families, and just let them know, like, we're here. We're here to do life with them. We're here to just pour all of that we have into them and just, you know, keep breathing vision and life into them. So, you know, we have big plans, big dreams, but most importantly, big disciplines.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. All the parents say amen.
That's right.
Let's
right,
go.
I love that.
Make those beds.
Right.
And obviously, you're the creative one. I mean, it's all over you. And I mean, you know, you have such a passion for young people, too.
Yes.
And where did that all begin, and where do you kind of see it going in some degree?
You know, growing up in church and just experiencing that as a youth, and then, you know, going out into the world and experiencing the world, I got to see the best of both worlds in that. And I really have a passion to bring that to the youth so that they can see, you don't have to go to the world. Let's just focus on what the Lord says for us to do and make it, it's natural. Let's make it cool. You know, you don't have to be, you know, cheesy cookie cutter. If you're artistic, be artistic.
Yeah.
You know, like, if you're sporty, be sport. Whatever you are, be that in what God has called you to.
I gotta tell you, man, I gotta give you some insight. You know, they go through an interview process. We have a pretty vigorous interview process, right? So the last process was some of the kids, and they interviewed them. And my daughter, when she came on the Zoom, the first thing she noticed was your hair, your glasses. Really, it was your glasses, your look. And I'm walking by, and I'm trying not to listen. I'm trying to let them do it. And I walk by, and she looks at me. She goes, and then I pointed at him, and I said, him? And she goes, I said, then I pointed at you. She goes, you know, and so, you know, at the end of the day, listen, you know, I love your looks. I love, most of all, I love your guys' spirits. I've known you guys for a while. And, you know, I've been trying honestly to lure them here for a very long time. But, you know, it wasn't the right time. But God's timing is always best. And,
Amen.
You know, Pastor Jeff is a phenomenal leader. His new nickname, we have to lay it out there, okay? His new nickname is called PJ2. Okay, it's okay, called PJ2, okay? The reason why is because we have Pastor Jeff, right? So when me and my wife are talking, we're always like,
Which one?
She goes, which one are you talking about, right? So I'm like, well, he's not number two in being number two, he's just number two, okay? That's just what it is. So his new nickname is PJ2, because then we have PJ.
We got to give honor where honor is.
Yeah, right.
See, Jeff came first.
Yeah, so that's
come
right.
On,
and they're best friends, too. So at the end of the day, it's not going to hit. But we're one big family. And parents, listen, we're going to be having a meet and greet coming up very soon.
Yes.
We're going to be unveiling the vision. We're going to take a whole weekend in just a few more weeks as Pastor Jeff will be speaking. He didn't know that. I just said that. And really unveiling the vision for
Amen.
Our students that we've really been working on for a while. And listen, at the end of the day, I've said it from day one. I'm on this stage today because my mother never gave me a choice to go to church.
Amen.
She says, as long as I'm in that house, you're going to church.
Yep.
And friends, listen, you're gonna have to drag your kids.
Yes.
But I'd say this, and I say this, and I used to tell parents all the time when I was a youth pastor, I'd say this, what would you rather do?
Mm.
Would you rather drive your son and your daughter to church even when you didn't feel like going? Maybe you didn't feel like logging on. Or would you rather go visit your kids in prison?
Mm.
Something's gonna happen. You're either gonna have to find your kids in the world,
Hmm.
or you can drive them and get them online at church. We need your help. We're doing our part. We need you to do yours. So let's pray for them, man. Father, we thank you for this incredible family. And we thank you for
Jesus.
Jeff and Deb and their beautiful children. Hmm. And Lord, thank you for bringing them to our family. And Lord, I know they're in this for the long haul. I know, God, they want to see not only our kids on fire for God, but they want to see them fulfill their purpose.
Yes.
You know, Jesus, as Deb said, she wants to see them come into their uniqueness,
mm-hmm.
their unique destinies, God. And Lord, we're not here to create clones or try to make them who they're not. Lord, we're really trying to point them to the God-given destiny they have for their life. And so we bless them and we bless their children and we pray, God, that they will be such a blessing to the families, as Pastor Jeff said. And so we love you and we honor you in Jesus' name. And all God's people say, amen. Why don't you check out what's happening right here at Destiny Church?
Hey Destiny family, here's what's happening this week at Destiny Church. We have a very special upcoming Winning Wednesday. It's our Vision Night. Yes, Vision Night. Pastor Obed will be pouring out his vision for our church for 2021. So make sure to join us this Wednesday, January 27th. Life groups are back. We believe here at Destiny that life is better with community. Head over to destiny.align/lifegroups or go to our app to sign up for a life group that is perfect just for you. Parents, you have been doing amazing during quarantine. Have your amazing Destiny kids come and interact with us, whether it is in life groups, Sunday service, or joining us for Spirit Week. Make sure to follow us on Facebook and Instagram at destinykids.online. Thanks for joining us online, Destiny family. Be sure to stay connected with us and follow us on all of our social media accounts, as well as making sure to download our church app. Our pastors and our digital dream team are always excited to engage with you. Well, hey, you are all that and a bag of chips with a Kit Kat in the bag. We love you, Destiny family.
Welcome, everybody. Welcome to Church at Home, and what a joy it is to come to you today. Listen, today is the day that we break our fast. And I don't know about you, but it has been a tremendous reward for so many, including myself. In Rial, and what I fasted this year was the news and social media. And so I'm really oblivious of everything that's been taking place. But I'm so glad that I've been cleansed by all of it and really being able to use that time to dive deeper in the Word, spend more time with Jesus instead of watching all the news, really getting the good news of the Word of God in my life. Well, hey, what I want to do before we get started is I want to remind you that at the end of the service, I don't need you to log off because we're going to break our fast with communion together. And so if you want to gather your elements right now, you can listen, but get back because I really believe God has a word for us today. I want to end this series on holy habits, talking about my great reward. The Bible says in Romans chapter 7, verse 15, it's been our theme verse this month. It says, I'm a mystery to myself, for I want to do what is right, but I end up doing what my moral instincts condemn. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the spirit of revelation. Give our minds illumination that we would experience transformation. God, I pray you give us a mind to perceive and a heart to receive all that you have. And I ask that after this message, we will never be the same. In Jesus' name, and all God's people say amen. You know, the interesting thing about Paul was here's a man that contributed to 3/4 of New Testament theology, and yet he had his own struggles. As spiritual as he was, as the times that he prayed and fasted like you and I, he still had his flesh to deal with. And this is why one translation says that Paul says, why do I do the things I hate to do, but yet I find myself doing those? And I really believe that at the end of the day, for you and I, if we want to achieve everything God has for us this year and literally live the extraordinary life, it's going to take more than just us praying prayers, getting in the Word, worshiping God. It's going to take some intentionalities in our life to bring us to the right disciplines by creating the right types of habits. I started this series by teaching you how to start the right habits. And we used a man named Daniel. That Daniel had distinguished and exceptional qualities. The reality is that I taught you that excellence is not what you're going into. It's not there. It's not where. Excellence begins with the choice. And once you make that choice of excellence, it brings you into the dedication that comes with action. And once you have the action that's producing the dedication because of the choice you made with excellence, it then brings you into disciplines that creates a new mindset. That new mindset that brings these disciplines comes by action that you have dedicated yourself to that really started with the choice of excellence that eventually lands you at the place where you want to be, and that's leadership, and that's the lifestyle. That lifestyle of leadership that Daniel had started with the right disciplines that created a mindset in him. But what happened was, is it started with the dedication that really started with the choice of living excellent. And I want to encourage you that everything about life, all about the complexities that you are dealing with, whether they're external or they're internal, none of those should stop you from every day being intentional by making the right choice that I'm going to live my life with excellence. The one thing you want to make sure you do this year is that you don't live life circumstantial. That, in other words, circumstances are the very things that dictate who I am. When all reality, God has already given you the power to decide who you want to be and where you want to go. And it begins with a choice. And friends, this year you have to decide that I'm not going to submit to the circumstances, nor am I going to fall prey to lowering my standards, my visions, and my dreams by the circumstances that I'm facing. But rather, I'm going to be like Daniel. I'm going to start every morning morning by making a choice that I'm going to live with excellence. I'm not going to live with mediocrity. I'm not going to live average. I'm not going to live common. And then all of a sudden, you will begin to step into the right habits that God has for your life. And then last week, I talked to you about stopping bad habits like Samson. You know, the Bible says in Judges chapter 16, verse 1, it says, one day Samson went to Gaza where he saw a prostitute. He went in to spend the night with her. I shared with you how ridiculous this habit was in the life of Samson, that literally Gaza was the Philistines' headquarters, which was his public enemy number one. It would almost be like you going to a place where that is your top enemy. That is the enemy that's after you, but yet your habit drove you there. I taught you that Gaza was 25 miles from Samson's hometown of Zorah, which meant that he had to go a distance in order to fulfill that satisfaction of that habit. And you and I have to understand that bad habits will cause longevity and distances in your life for the simple reason is that you don't know how to sit there and understand your trigger points and just stop. And I taught you that he was dumb enough to risk so much for so little, yet countless people do this every day. And what we learned is that we end up in the wrong places, not because we're wrong people. It's because we've taken on the wrong habits. Which leads me to what I've really been trying to articulate to you and really get it in your spirit, which are the three R's of habit formation. And for us to really understand that, that first is a reminder. That reminder is the stimulus that actually starts the habit. Then there's the routine. That's the doing of the habit and the behavior itself. And then finally, the reward, the benefit associated with it. And I used the illustration that I hope you would always remember because you deal with this all the time. And that's you being at a stoplight. It's red. You're stopped. You're listening to worship music or a podcast, whatever it may be. And all of a sudden, the light turns green, which is a reminder. A reminder of what? A trigger. It's reminding you you can go. Now, all of a sudden, you step into the routine in which you are now crossing that intersection that eventually is going to bring you to the reward that you finally end up at your destination. You see, when you and I understand that bad habits can also turn into good habits, and the way those good habits are established are the same way they're reinforced when they're wrong. You see, every day you are either reinforcing good habits or you are reinforcing bad habits. And the way you stop bad habits is by understanding your reminders and stopping there and not allowing them to become the routine that eventually brings you a temporary satisfaction, which is just a temporary reward. I showed you last week and I challenged you. Do not fall for the immediate while sacrificing the ultimate. Friends, it's gonna take you time to fulfill your dreams. It's gonna take time for you to get to where you are, to where God wants you to be. And the one thing that the enemy would want you to do is fall back into bad habits and fall prey to the immediate. Those satisfactions, those moments that come that in some sense are drawing you back to where you once were. The truth is that if I understand my reminders, I'm not going to fall into the routine and receive the wrong reward. But if I actually understand my reminders and start a new routine, it's going to eventually bring me into a new and fulfilling reward. In other words, our external goals will only be reached by our internal new habits. Let me say it like this, that where you are today was determined by the habits that you took on. That in other words, if I want to go further in life, I want to experience a different kind of life, a more fulfilled life, an extraordinary life, it just doesn't begin with vision. It begins with creating the habits that are necessary for me to get there and be fulfilled when I arrive. See, at the end of the day, if all you have this year are just goals, and all you have this year is just vision, then you're probably going to land up staying in the same place you're at because you never took time to re-examine your life and ask yourself the questions, do my habits today match the vision and my goals of my tomorrow? And most of us would sit there and say no, including myself. I got big dreams. I got big goals this year. But I had to look at myself and ask myself this question, do my habits today match up and can get me to my dreams and my vision for my tomorrows, which led me to go through the same journey I'm taking you through, examining my life, looking at where I need to change bad habits and turn them into healthy habits, good habits. I was talking to a friend of mine who really, in some sense, through our conversation, convicted me. You know, he was talking about his life and he was talking about how fast his life was going in 2020. Unlike a lot of us, where we went working from an office to a home, his business, in some sense, never closed its doors. They only really had a week off. And then they were right back in the office working. And matter of fact, it kind of escalated and he was just living a fast life. Well, during this COVID fast life that he had taken on, his eating habits changed. You know, he always prided himself in eating healthy and all of a sudden, because life was so fast, he just went after fast food and went after those poor eating habits. And he found himself getting tired, not having enough strength. And then as he began to set himself up and set some goals for 2021 and take his business to a greater place, he knew with the eating habits that he had would not last. He sat there and he told me something that really struck a bell with me. He said, Obet, he says, aren't our bodies the temple of the Holy Spirit? Like God created our bodies to carry his spirit everywhere we go. And he goes, you know, it dawned on me one day that the creator of the universe lives inside of me. And the building that he chose was my body. And if I'm good at taking care of my house and taking care of my building that I own, why don't I take that same conviction that I have with my own body? Basically, he was telling me, my habits I have right now will not take me into the dreams of my tomorrow. And I think, friends, we all got to look at that. A few weeks ago, I was working with a team and I challenged them. And I said, in all that you do and in the area of your expertise in this company, I'm going to give you one challenge. And I was coaching them, and the challenge that I gave them was, I'm going to challenge you to wake up a half an hour earlier than you normally do. And in that half an hour, I want you to take time to study about your place and position. Well, a few weeks passed and I get a call from the CEO and he says, man, I got to tell you about our executive meeting that we had today. He says, people were talking about all the stuff they have learned, all the stuff they've grown into by just that one challenge you gave us. Waking up an extra half an hour earlier, learning more about what I do, dedicating that time. He said, Obed, I would, you know this, I would be the one that would come with all the ideas and all the marketing strategies. And I gotta let you know that really this was one of the first meetings I had that I didn't really even open up my mouth with all the ideas that I came with, because everybody came with theirs. One tweak to a new habit got them one step closer to their dreams for tomorrow. What if you just woke up a half an hour earlier, go to bed a half an hour earlier, and said, I'm going to dedicate these 30 minutes to reading the Word, having devotion, listening to worship, jumping on at 6 o'clock in the morning for the Life and Leadership podcast, growing my life. Imagine that new habit that you created. Think about how closer it can get you to your dreams of tomorrow. But if you think that just because I got dreams and just because I got goals and God's gonna honor it, and yet there's no personal responsibility that I gotta take, and if you think you're gonna get there, friends, you're probably not. See, the reality is I really believe that the church, in some sense, on one end, has tremendous reliability on God. Like, I'm going to be reliable on God, and God, you're going to do everything for me, and if I pray it, it's going to happen, and we got this whole reliability down. But what's missing is the other side, which is responsibility. Reliability, I'm going to rely on God. He's going to do everything for me. But then on the other hand, there's responsibility. That's my part in the equation. And it's like all of us this year went into 2021 wanting a better year than last year. And we're sitting there saying, God, I believe that 2021 is going to be awesome. I believe it's going to be extraordinary. I believe you're going to do amazing things. Reliability. We're going to rely on God. And I could just imagine God looking down at us and saying, okay, I love the fact that you are relying on me. Lean not on your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge me. I love that. But where is your personal responsibility in this equation as well? It's one thing to have reliability and sit around and wait for God to do the miraculous. It's the other thing of taking personal responsibility, doing an examination in your life, and asking God, what type of new habits do I need to create to get to my dreams tomorrow? Because at the end of the day, if I have reliability and responsibility, then friends, we're going to see come to pass the year of the extraordinary that God has promised us. But don't think for a moment it's all on God and not yourself. This is why you have to understand that at the core of discipleship is discipline. I want to give you three things today that I truly believe can help you get over the edge, get to the tipping point, and fall on the other side of creating a life with new habits that's going to bring you into your dreams and your goals of tomorrow. The first thing you got to understand, number one, is this, is that discipline is choosing what you want most over what you want now. I'm going to say that again. Discipline, number one, is choosing what you want most over what you want now. Solomon talks about it in Proverbs chapter 1. He writes and he says, whoever loves discipline loves knowledge, but whoever hates correction is stupid. Not my words, Solomon's. Job 5:17 says this. It says, blessed is the one whom God corrects. He says, so do not despise the discipline of the Almighty. And friends, when you go from making bad habits to good habits that are going to take you into your dreams and your visions of tomorrow, it's going to take a determination of creating the right disciplines for your life. Don't think waking up at the same time last year, this year, is going to get you one step closer to your dream. Don't think that the things you did last year that you're going to do this year are going to get you one step closer to your dream. It's almost foolish to think that I'm going to set bigger goals with the same type of mediocrity lifestyle that I have today. Friends, we got to get past the fact that everything is on God and none of it is our own personal responsibility. I understand. I get it. You have these desires. I know you want it for your life. But I want to help you the way God's helped me. You see, at the end of the day, desires don't determine who you become. Disciplines do. We can have all the desire in the world. Boy, I'm going to make it in life. Man, I'm going to fulfill that vision. I'm going to go after that dream. Man, we all got those desires, but let me just help you out. And that is, desires don't determine who you become. Disciplines do. Matter of fact, to kind of just give it straightforward, your life today is just a reflection of your disciplines. That, man, if you actually want more, to be more and to do more, you gotta go past desire and turn those into disciplines. The second thing is that discipline is choosing the ultimate and not falling for the immediate. Discipline is choosing the ultimate and not falling for the immediate. David writes in Psalms 91, he says this, with long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. In other words, what God is talking about is that discipline prepares you for the long game. You know, I love this generation. I'm 47, and I keep on telling you that. I think I've been telling you that every week because I'm really, you know, wanting you to know that I am 47. I know I look like I'm 27, but I am 47. And I love this generation. I love their passion. I love their creativity. I love their innovation. But one of the great challenges of this next generation is they want to get there fast. I want it now. And the truth is, I've been telling you, is that the goal shouldn't be that you want to get there fast more than you want to get there prepared. The goal is not to get there. The goal is to last when you get there. And yet, the visions and the dreams that we have for our tomorrows come with the right disciplines that we take on today. But it also has to be that we're committed for the long game. Because it's so easy to sabotage success by just other opportunities that come to distract you from the course that you set yourself out to commit to. You see, I've taught you for so many years that the only way the devil can defeat you is distract you. He can't really kill you. He doesn't hold the keys of life or death. So his weapon is to distract you. I've told you that the best way to kill your vision is just give yourself another one. Because the truth is that we all want to be something. We all want to be somewhere. But I've learned that direction is a lot better than speed. That I'm in this for the long haul. And as one great general of the faith told me, he says, Obed, you'll always make it if you're determined to outlast your enemy. I often think how so many of us We're so focused on the ultimate until we were confronted with the desire for the immediate. And we fell prey to the immediate. And now we're looking back and going, God, I sold myself short of the ultimate. I guess the question really leads to is, why do we start strong and end weak? Why is it that everybody in January starts off in the gym, but don't last until March? Why is it that, man, we were all excited when 11:59 came, and that midnight hour was just 30 seconds away, and we were counting down, and we were so excited about the new year because of new goals and the new you. Why is it that we start so strong, but we end so weak? The first is, was that it was your goal, but it never became your passion. You had all these goals, but those goals never translated into passion. Friends, goals after a month get boring. Especially when they take time to become achievable. It's sexy when it starts, when you're talking about it, but when you're in it for a while, it loses its sexiness, becomes boring, and then we quit. All of a sudden, friends come around and they ask you about that goal that you had, and you almost clamped up to the shame. Well, I'm not really doing that anymore. Why? Man, the last time I talked to you, you were so excited about it. Yeah. I guess it just wasn't me. No, the truth was, you never took the goal and translated it into your passion. The next is that goals always start off as blessings, but the reason why they don't last is because you've allowed it to turn it into a burden. Man, I'm excited about these goals, dreams and vision, and now all of a sudden, 3 months later, you're in it for the long haul, and oh, this has become a burden. Man, I don't really want to go to the gym, man. I know I'm supposed to today. I've been going 5 days a week. I cut down to four. Just going every day is just tough. It's a burden. It's becoming a problem. I just don't have the time no more. Why do we quit? Because what started off as a blessing turned into a burden. And the other reason why we start strong and end weak is that you feel you're not getting anywhere. Let me help you for a moment. The goal of every day is to win it. I'm going to win my day. But the goal should never be about the gap more than it should be focused on the gain. Listen to me. Listen to me. Because what's going to frustrate you when you're in the long haul, what's going to frustrate you and lose the passion that that vision and that dream started with, is that you're so focused on the gap that you're not even giving yourself a reward for the gain. That if I can just focus every day on the gain and not really pay attention to the gap, then if I choose every day to win my day and get that gain that I need to today, then every single day I'm gaining and I'm gaining and I'm gaining. And one day you're going to look up and that gap at one point seems so far. And the next time you look at it, you're going to see it, that you're so closer to it. And therefore the gap doesn't intimidate you or frustrate you no more. Why? Because the simple thing you did was take your eyes off of the gap from where you are to where your dreams are tomorrow. And you started to focus on the gains. And that's what I've been doing, friends. Every single day, I've been reminding myself, Obed, you made a gain today. Obed, you made a gain today. I'm not focused on the gap. The gap is intimidating. The gap, in some sense, is going to snuff my passion. The gap, therefore, is going to remind me that it's not achievable. But all things are possible with God. As long as we take one step at a time and we look at it and say, today I'm going to make a gain, I'm not going to focus on the gap. And then lastly, number three, as I close, we get ready for communion. Discipline is choosing God power over willpower. You know, the Bible says in Proverbs 3, it says, trust in the Lord completely. Do not rely on your own opinions, but with all your heart, rely on Him to guide you. And He will lead you in every decision you make. Become intimate with Him in whatever you do, and He will lead you wherever you go. Can I tell you something? I think if you look back and see all the goals you've ever set, I believe at the core of them was willpower. I got the willpower to do it. I can make it happen. And now you realize it's not willpower, it's God power. The truth is, who you want to become has to be greater than what you want. Who you want has to become greater than what you want. I understand we have goals. I understand we have vision. I understand we have dreams. That's the what. But the who should be more important to you than the what. If I can focus these next 11 months on the who, the what and the where is going to become naturally done, and by me getting there. Friends, as we prepare for communion, our worship team is going to come and sing this song called Here Again. And I want you to lean in, because we're going to break our fast. We're going to have communion together. And then I'm going to pray for you. And I'm going to pray that from this moment on, the who becomes more important than the what. And that this will be the day that new habits are established. New disciplines are created. And over the next 11 months, instead of reinforcing bad habits and bad disciplines, we're going to reinforce good habits and good disciplines. Let's worship the Lord.
Though we want Jesus,
your glory.
What an amazing song and what an incredible presence. But more importantly, what an incredible moment we're in right now. You know, I was sharing this week in our Life and Leadership podcast that time is measured in minutes, but life is measured in moments. You know, people don't remember the time more than they remember the moments. Right now, we're in a moment. I believe a moment in which you can and will be able to look back next year and remember that this moment changed the trajectory of your life. As you have your elements of communion and we break our fast, Jesus was with his disciples and he spoke of his body metaphorically, symbolically, of bread, and he broke it. He broke it because he wanted them to get a picture of what a broken life looks like and yet how he can heal it. Bad habits create broken lives. And as we partake today, let's ask God to heal the areas in our life that bad habits have created. Father, we lift up the bread, this cracker. We break it to remind us that we are broken because of sin. Yet you took on the stripes to heal us. And as we partake, let the healing power of God flow. In Jesus' name shall we partake. Jesus took the cup. He said, "This is my blood that represents a new covenant, a new day, a new era." And can I tell you that the end of an era is not the completion of a destiny? It's just a new chapter. And we're starting one today. We're never going back to bad habits. Lift up the cup. Lord, forgive us for reinforcing bad habits, reinforcing routines that we know you're not pleased with. So we ask today that by your precious blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary would forgive us of our sins, our iniquities, and all of our impurities. We ask that you make us whiter than snow. We ask you to come into our hearts and be the Lord of our life today. In Jesus' name, shall we partake. Friends, we really believe that the next 11 months, God's gonna move you from the ordinary into the extraordinary. Be committed to the change, and your future will be committed to you. We're gonna pass you on to your campus pastors. We love you. We'll see you this Wednesday. Be blessed, everybody.
Honey, wasn't that a great, great message, man? What a way to end our 21 days, breaking our 21 days of prayer and fasting.
It was so good.
Such a word, man, such a word, honey. I mean, it's just preparing us.
Preparing us. And I loved point number two, which said, discipline is choosing the ultimate and not falling for the immediate.
Wow, wow, wow. Yes. You know, because discipline, mm-hmm. and the quote was, discipline prepares us for the long game.
The long game.
The long game. And so we're learning, guys, in this whole 21 days of breaking bad habits, we're learning how to say no yes. to the good things mm-hmm. and yes to the great things. And
yes
so going for the ultimate of what yeah. God really has for us in our lives.
Don't get tripped up and fall for the immediate.
Yes, yes,
there's
yes.
great
yes,
things
yes.
ahead.
Yes, so many great things. And speaking of great things, you know, if you were to die today, would you be able to say that you prepared and that you know the Lord?
Wow.
You know, and so preparing, as we said, for the ultimate, preparing for that ultimate gift, mm-hmm. man, to be with Jesus and to be with our Father in heaven, you know?
Right.
And this is what it's all about, man, living that disciplined life.
Yes.
In order for us to receive our internal reward.
Yes.
And so, man, if that's you, say, hey, I don't know about Christ. I've never received Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. What we want to do today, man, we want to lead you in the prayer, man,
yeah.
that we want you to be able to be part of the kingdom and part of the family of God, man.
Yes.
And so if that's you, what I want you to do right now is just repeat after me and say, Heavenly Father, forgive me of my sins. I know that your son Jesus.
I know that your son Jesus
died on the cross
for my sins,
and he rose again.
And he rose again
unto my salvation. For the word of God says,
If I confess with my mouth,
and believe within my heart, that Jesus Christ is Lord,
I will be saved. be saved.
And Lord, today,
I confess you
as my Lord and Savior.
I thank you
for saving me.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Come on, if that was you, man, we just want to celebrate you today, man. Tell your story. Let someone know that how your life has changed today.
Yes. A brand new you.
Well, man, we hope you guys enjoyed us. And join us again, man. We just love being with you guys.
Yes,
we love coming into your homes. As you can see, we're in our home and coming into your homes. We just love being with them. I love being with the people of God.
Yes, our online family.
Yes. Hey, so once again, this Wednesday, somebody say this Wednesday.
This Wednesday.
You want to make sure that you catch our service this Wednesday. And because the state of the church, Pastor will be speaking about the state of the church, the five things that he's going to be sharing with us about the greatness of the things that's going to take place in 2021. And also join Pastor Obed on Monday morning for his podcast. At what time, honey?
6 a.m. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And of course, you don't want to miss us, Marriage Monday, every Monday night at 8 p.m. And man, that's us growing our marriage as we grow your marriage together, man. And we're excited, man. We have so much fun on there. And so, man, join us as well. But other than that, honey, I hope you have a great day today. Yes, I will, because I will be with you. And I hope you guys have an amazing day, amazing evening. If you're watching our evening service, and once again, from the bottom of our hearts, and from the bottom of our pastors, our senior pastors, Pastor Obed and Pastor Lissette, we want to say that we love you.
We love you.
Have the best day of the week, or the best week.
Yes.
And know that you are a what? A
bag of chips.
With
a Kit Kat in the bag.
And
a Mountain Dew on the side.
We love you guys. We'll see you soon.
Bye-bye.